Ahoy, fellow Vita comrades, and welcome! Today we are first looking at apps like Auto Plugin 2 and Easy Plugin. We are trying to determine whether or not you should use them. And later we are checking out the best plugins that every Vita owner needs to install. So let's get cracking! First, what it even is plugin, you may ask? Plugin is a micro program that runs in the background of your Vita and it enhances your experience. How it enhances it? Well, depends what plugin you use. From enhancing the saturation of the LCD screen on your PS Vita Slim, to enabling video output to PC or Android, here only sky is the limit. All the plugins can be easily installed manually, they always go into UR0 TIE folder, so you just download the plugin, put it into UR0 TIE folder, and add one line of text into the config.txt, usually under kernel, then reboot, and that's literally it. I've created 60-second short where I explain everything step by step. Check it out if you are interested. Link in the right corner. Now, many people are not bothered by installing plugins manually. They want the app to do it for them. And that's where Easy Plugin or Auto Plugin 2 comes to help. These apps install plugins automatically, so you just pick the one you want, click on it, confirm with X, reboot and job done. If somebody asks about plugin on our Discord, this is the answer one gets. Why you shouldn't use Auto Plugin? Number 1. It doesn't always make the changes correctly. Number 2. People think they can just install everything. Number 3. If you install it with app, you'll never learn how to manually install and remove them. And number 4. The directory includes many outdated and conflicted plugins. Then there is a link for article with the title Robot Does Break, where the author explains everything you need to know about plugins, plus some basic troubleshooting in case anything goes wrong. Link for the article is down below, and here is the most important part. Quote, sometimes Auto Plugin will fail. We know that Auto Plugin 1 tends to corrupt the config.txt, recently also Auto Plugin 2, but the issue has been solved with the later update. Auto Plugin is a great homebrew, but it shouldn't completely replace the knowledge of plugins, and you cannot expect it to be fail-proof. End quote. And what exactly does it mean? Should you use it or should you rather avoid it? The answer is very simple. Do what you want, brother. It's your Vita, so do as you please. But please, stick to these very important rules. Number 1. Only install plugins that you necessarily need and that you can't live without. And the ones that you don't use regularly every day, rather deactivate. How? Simply go to your config.txt. And let's say you want to deactivate this one, so you just delete the last letter, save modifications, reboot, and that's it. And in case you want to use it again in the future, you just add the letter back, save it, and reboot. As simple as that. Or at least that's my way of doing it. Second rule, always use the latest versions of the apps and stick to the Easy Plugin or Auto Plugin too. Easy Plugin is loading quite a bit longer and it's very simple, a very bare bones app. Whereas Auto Plugin 2 has much more features available to your disposal. It can even auto-update itself, there are even some HD patches for games available, you can install or uninstall plugins, and download even some apps like Yamt, yet another mounting tool, Battery Fixer, ITL Zenso, and so on. Rule number 3. Do not install too many plugins. Yeah, I know it's similar like rule number 1, but here I want to reiterate that some plugins are more resource hungry, some plugins are just incompatible with each other, and I'm sure you know how the probability works. The more plugins you install, the higher the probability that something will eventually go wrong and you end up in a boot loop or something. It is not the end of the world, but that's what you want to prevent. Also guys, if you are enjoying this video, like and subscribe, cause there is certainly more to come. Also consider to join and become a member. I've created this video from the member's suggestion, cause even that is possible. Now, let's check some quintessential plugins that every Vita gamer needs to have. If you've downgraded to 3.65 Enzo via Vita Deploy, you have these plugins installed out of box. OSysCo 6 for playing higher firmware games on lower firmware systems. No MPDRM necessary for playing games from PKGJ. No power limits. It removes brightness and Wi-Fi restrictions for games. PNG Shot, plugin that makes screenshots great again, in PNG format, no watermark, and in any app. PS Visual, my favorite one, for overclocking and for frame rate. Do not use the old frame counter, this one is way better. Repatch for easier customization of your games, VitaBright for better control of your brightness limits, you can go dimmer and brighter, and ShellBot for showing percentage for the battery on the live area. If you install SD to Vita, there are more plugins installed but all automatically. This is a PS Vita port channel and three main plugins that almost every single port requires are FDFix, don't use it if you are using Repatch, then Kubridge, and last one is Shader Compiler plugin. First two can be installed normally, but for the Shader Compiler, you can either install VitaDB app, and that will do it all in one click automatically, or you can just install SharkBrit app, which will do the trick without the VitaDB app. More essential plugins are ITLS Enzo. It adds TLS to Enzo-enabled devices. You install this one via VPK. Another very useful plugin is NoPSM DRM for playing all the PlayStation mobile games. Gepatch that allows some PSP game to run at Vita Native's resolution. Check compatibility list. Remastered Controls plugin for using both sticks with PSP games like Vice City Stories and Liberty City Stories. There is also Vita Cheat for cheats. Vita Graphics for changing resolution and FPS cap. Revita for remapping any of the buttons and touch surfaces. PSV Game SD that can dump your PS Vita cartridges to internal storage. Then there are a bunch of plugins that are especially useful for PSTV users like SharpScale, Native Resolution Output plugin, Dolce Polce, that's like a whitelister for all the blacklisted games on the PSTV. Fake Camera plugin for faking camera in games that requires it. Mini Vita TV for connecting up to 4 controllers at the same time at one PSTV or at one Vita. Vixen for using wired X input controllers like Xbox 360 controller. Then there are also plugins for using wireless controllers like Xbox One controller, DualShock 3, DualShock 4, 8-bit Do, V-Mode, you can even use the touch surface on the DualShock 4, and there is also a plugin for enabling gyro aiming. This video serves mainly as a highlight to provide you with some useful information. If you want to find out more about any of these plugins, please Google it. You can find many useful discussions on the Reddit, etc. In the end, I repeat, please only use plugins that you need. For example, on my main Vita, the only extra plugins I use regularly are PSV Shell, no MPDRM, no power limits, VitaBright, OC Scroll, ITLS, and three main ports plugins. That's it, all the rest is inactive. So please be mindful about it, like you're not gonna brick your Vita, but you're gonna save yourself some troubleshooting, which is always worth it. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to not miss upcoming one. Thanks to you for watching, thanks to devs for hard work, thanks to members for support. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out. Как это?